So you want to install a TRYX Panorama 360 AIO into your PC, and you need a little help. Well, you've come to the right place, because right here on Robeytech, we're gonna walk you through installing this AIO step by step so you can confidently install it into your system and have it up and running in no time. Specifically, in this video, we're gonna cover what's in the box, unboxing, we're gonna prep your motherboard for the AIO, mounting the AIO inside of your PC, mounting the pump to an AMD system, as well as mounting the pump to an Intel system, so you're fully covered there, connecting all the cables, and you being good to go. Now, if you're looking for a full overview of the AIO, don't worry, we got you covered there as well. You can check out our full review of the TRYX Panorama 360 right here. So if you want to know about the performance and nuances, you can check out that video. But enough of me talking, let's get started with unboxing the TRYX Panorama 360. Inside here, and I have to say, this is actually pretty cool the way that they did this, because it's like all wrap around. So first thing we got inside here, pump and fans, and they're all connected. And then the box does not come out for this, so inside we've got some cables, we got all of your mounting gear, Intel bracket, Intel standoff screws, our AMD universal bracket for Asetek, and these are for AM5 Intel LGA 1700 thumb screws to mount your AIO. So these are for AM4 and Intel LGA 115X and LGA 1200. This comes with thermal paste, your AIO connection box, connects all the cables and all that sort of stuff, your USB and all your connections that you need to connect the box to the motherboard, adhesive for either connecting it via magnet or via plastic. You have your radiator mounting screws. And then lastly, our TRYX Panorama user manual. Now we're gonna start by getting motherboards prepped, and we're gonna do this for both AMD and Intel, but we're gonna kick it off alphabetically by starting with AMD. Now for AMD, what you're gonna need for this part, the universal bracket for Asetek pumps, your thermal paste, and a standard screwdriver. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna start removing the stock bracket from the motherboard, and make sure that you save the screws. You do not wanna get rid of the screws or place them in your motherboard box. You wanna, these screws you're gonna need for the universal bracket. We're gonna start with the top one. Notice it says CPU and it's pointing at an arrow. The same one's on the other one. Make sure the CPU is in between the two. So when I place this down, you see that it's pointing to CPU in the middle. And this works for both AM4 and AM5. So both AMD will be the same way. Now we're gonna apply thermal paste. The reason we're doing the dot method is so you can get a full coverage of the IHS. That's the reason we put it all across the CPU like this. Okay, so now let's get our motherboard prepped for Intel. Now the things you're gonna need for Intel are specifically back bracket for Intel, and you have your standoff screws for Intel. So this is an LGA 1700 socket, but yours may look different. The most important thing is, you see these four holes, you basically need to adjust this bracket so it fits in these four holes. So this does not have adhesive, but you're just gonna basically adjust them and move it in, hold it, and then flip it over. Next, you want to screw your posts in, and you want to screw them down until they're all the way tight. You see the curved tip versus the non-curved tip? You're gonna want to screw in to the back plate using the curved tip. Actually, it's very hard to do it the other way, so just a little bit of like advice on how to get it into the back plate easier. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna put mini dots and make a pattern all the way across the IHS. This will give you very even coverage of the entire IHS. Basically, motherboard's prepped. Now what we're gonna do is we're going to get this installed inside of the case. So what we need for that is pretty simple. So we need the AIO, and we need our screws, and then we also need our regular screwdriver. Okay, so one other quick note before we put this inside is, if you have already installed your rear fan, you may wanna actually lower it down to make sure that you have the room to basically easily install your AIO. Or you can install it afterwards, that's up to you. If you pre-installed it, I like to just basically just have it sit there and dangle. But you know, the big thing is you just wanna make sure that the AIO is the right size to fit inside of your case, and we're assuming you've done that. So we're gonna set this nicely inside of the case, like so. The main reason we do this is so we can grab this cable here, and you wanna basically run it through the center portion of your case. As I'm pulling this cable back, you just want to lift up and then center your radiator right there, making sure that you can see all the screw holes at the top. Then what we're going to do is we're going to start in the front corner. Then we're going to do the front corner here. I'm not gonna tighten these all the way in, and then I'm gonna push it all the way forward, as far forward as it can go. Main reason being is that these tubes are in the back by this fan, and you wanna make sure that the fan and the tubes don't touch each other. So you wanna give it as much room as possible. And then, now we can just screw in the rest. Okay, so one note, the way it comes out of the box from TRYX is that the tubes are on the left-hand side. If you wanted to switch them to the other side, all you're gonna have to do is remove the fans and literally switch them so the cables are the other direction, and that'll allow you to have the tubes on the other side. The only thing that's really important is when you basically do mounting, which we'll show here in a minute, that the tubes are at the bottom once you mount the pump. But you are able to move the tubes to the side. All you gotta do is remove the fans and rotate them. It's pretty straightforward. Now we're actually gonna show you how to mount the AIO onto both AMD and Intel motherboards. Now, obviously we're doing this outside of the case. The reason being is we wanna make sure that you can really see how to mount it, which makes it a whole lot easier for you. And then of course you're gonna be doing this inside of the case. Okay, so for mounting the AIO to AMD, you're going to need your screwdriver. And then depending on if you're AM4 or AM5, it will be different screws to mount the AIO to the actual motherboard. So I will show when I go closer which one, depending on when we get to that mount point. Something I like about this AIO is that you do not need to keep this connected, so you can actually disconnect this and take it away. So then all you have is the pump and the PWM connection. So now what you're gonna do is you're going to take off the plastic. Now to mount this, you wanna make sure that the tubes are at the bottom and you're gonna place it down. Now, if you're doing AM5, like what we're doing, you're gonna wanna use these right here. So this is like Ryzen 7000 series and above. If you're doing AM4, which is like your Ryzen 5000 and below, you wanna use these right here. Now what I would do is just start each one with a couple spins. And once you've got them started, basically start in the top corner, give it like four spins, give it like five, and come to the other side. We're gonna go to the bottom, and we're gonna go to the top, and then just rinse and repeat that. And then once you're done three or four times, then you can just finish tightening them down all the way. Just make sure you do it in the star pattern. And then you wanna do it until it stops. Once you have your pump mounted, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this cable right here, which should be the only one that you see right now, and we're gonna plug this into either system optional or another fan header. Main reason being is that this is actually what powers your pump. If you don't have a CPU optional, that's okay. Don't plug it into CPU fan, just plug it into any of the other fan headers that are near the top. Now for Intel and mounting to an Intel motherboard, what you're gonna need is you're going to need your screwdriver, and then you have two different mounts based on which Intel CPU you are installing. Okay, so one thing I like about this particular AIO is that you can remove the screen. You're just gonna wanna pull this off right away and just set it off to the side. Is we're going to remove our plastic, and then with the tubes down at the bottom, you're going to set it just on top. If you're doing LGA 115X or LGA 1200, you're gonna use these. If you're doing LGA 1700, which is the latest 12th gen, 13th and 14th gen, you're gonna use these. So what I suggest doing is just hand screwing it on first, just to get it started, and just spin it like three or four times. Then starting in the corner, just gonna want to spin four or five times, then switch over to the opposite corner. One, two, three, four, five, in the far corner. And then you're just gonna repeat this pattern. And then once you've done the last, you've done it three or four times, now what you can do is you can essentially just tighten them all the way down, nicely tight. So make sure they go all the way down. We're gonna plug this one into CPU optional. And if you don't have a CPU optional on your motherboard, any of the other fan headers at the top will absolutely work. But if it has a CPU optional, that's where you wanna plug it in. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna connect all our cables. But before we do that, there's a little bit of cable management. You can see this cable that we've hooked up to, in this case, CPU optional, or it may be AIO pump or whatever it was. Now what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna tuck this in. Depending on your motherboard, I just tuck it down like that. I'm gonna be able to put the cover right over it, so it stays not visible. That's the key thing for me. You're gonna take the TRYX screen, take the USB cable. You can see it's actually got like a little lip here. You just wanna make sure it's up in the top corner here. You're gonna essentially take it, put it right over, so it's gonna magnetically sit on. And then you're gonna take this cable, you're gonna route it up and through the same place that you routed the other stuff. And then you're gonna kind of tuck it down underneath the same way so it stays hidden, and then it's up with your other cable. Now we're gonna talk about the controller. So there's two ways to actually do this with this AIO. One way is to use the controller, which this allows you to use Canali software to control all of your fan speeds and stuff like that, as well as your RGB. Or the second option is you can just take this and then you can connect this to a CPU header and you connect it to an RGB header, which you're seeing right there. And then that could also work. Recommendations for me is I prefer not to use controllers and software as much as possible. But again, that's up to you. I mean, this is gonna swallow up all your USB slots, but we're gonna show you how to do it with both, but both the controller and also with just normal. For this specific one, we have a PWM fan header, and then we have a 5-volt ARGB header. This is going to control the fans directly from your motherboard curve if you hook it up this way, and this will have your motherboard control your RGB as well. Is you're gonna connect this particular cable to your CPU fan header on your motherboard. Now, that all depends on your motherboard. And in our case, for this board, it's showing light gray, but that's not gonna be every board, so you're gonna need to look at your manual to make sure you can find this particular header. Every motherboard does have it. The next one is we're actually gonna plug in the ARGB connector, but because this doesn't have a 5-volt ARGB at the top, we actually have to use an extension to be able to plug it in. Now, we're gonna show you plugging in the extension into the motherboard. It's the exact same thing if you were plugging this in, so don't get hung up on the color. The connection to the MOBO is the same, but now let's go and get that hooked up. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna basically take our USB header from our screen, it says USB on it. You gotta find this on your motherboard. They're usually at the bottom and they can come in groups of two or three. Now for option two, using the controller. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna get our hub ready to magnetically connect. Now, if you were using a plastic case, you could take this off and stick this permanently onto your case. But given we're using metal, we're just gonna keep it and use it as magnetic. Now we're gonna connect our cables. This is the USB for controlling everything via software. Just gonna plug it in right here. This cable is optional. This cable allows you to have the motherboard control the RGB and then also have the motherboard know how fast things are moving. But if you don't care about those, you don't necessarily need to plug this in, but we're gonna show you how to connect everything. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna plug in the two power SATA connections into the PSU SATA. So you should have a cable that looks like this. You can see that they're in an L shape, so they're very easy. They only go in one way. And you need to connect both of these to make sure that the hub is powered. So there is, coming off of your AIO pump, a fan and an ARGB connection. Those are gonna plug into the ARGB one and fan one connection on the hub. Plug in the ARGB into the ARGB. Then we're gonna take the fan and we're gonna plug that into fan. So cable management is outside of the scope of this video, but before you place this permanently, make sure that you connect these other three connectors. So what we have left is we have USB, and then if you decided to install the ARGB and the fan header, remember those are optional, but we're gonna show you how to connect these three. Now we're gonna plug in our USB. The last one is the fan header. And then now the last cable, which comes right off of the screen for the AIO pump, is this USB cable. This as the last cable, and there you go. And now with everything connected, let's finish the rest of the build and let's get it turned on. So, ready to turn it on, everything's set. 3, 2, 1. And there we go, that is the installation of the TRYX Panorama 360 ARGB AIO. I hope this video was comprehensive and gave you everything that you needed to know to get this set up. We kind of showed you all the options and what to do and to get a setup that looks as good as this. One thing is that you need to use the Canali software. We're not doing obviously a guide on that given that the software changes all the time, but that's how you change the different graphics that are on the AIO. You can find out more about that in the review that we referenced earlier, and there's a link down in the description if you missed that link earlier on. So would love to know down in the comments, what did you think of this? Was it comprehensive enough? Was there anything we could have done better? Was there anything unclear? Because we're always trying to improve. So while you're down there, why don't you go ahead and slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. Also, if you have additional questions you want to ask more or maybe see if there's other options for AIOs, get over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts who love to talk about these things. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, follow us at Robeytech absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video. We look forward to seeing you on the next one.